Hi guys, welcome to the channel. I am Ankit and in this video we are going to learn how to generate PDF in PHP from MySQL database. Means whatever the data in the table we have, we will export that data and generate a PDF from there. So before starting the video guys, please subscribe. It costs nothing to you but helps a lot to me. So now let's start the video. So what we are going to do, we are going to use the mPDF package library of PHP. So but before that we need a composer is a dependency manager to install the packages and libraries. So just go to the Google and type composer. So this is a dependency manager for PHP. Just click on this download, a setup file will be downloaded, and this is simple setup. You can install via just click double click and next. So once this is done, so you can verify that composer install or not. So just in the command prompt just type composer, and if you see like this, it means the composer installed successfully and you are good to go. Now the next thing is we are using this package here, composer require mpdf/mpdf that is used to generate the PDF from the HTML. So yeah, you can just copy this command and paste into your terminal like this. And once you do this, guys, before hitting the command, you have to do create a composer.json file. So after the composer.json file is created, then you have to hit that package installation command. So after successful installation, the composer.json file will be updated like this, and this vendor folder will be created. This is a library. So now let's start doing the next of things. We have installed composer, we have installed the package, and let me show you the UI. So in the UI, what we are doing here means on click of this button, we will just export the data from the database. Let me show you the database. So this is database coding words, and this is the table. Inside the table, I have these 4 to 5 columns: name, email, contact, and amount. So we will be exporting name, email, and contact in the table, and we'll generate the PDF. So let's start. So before doing that, let's create a database file here, database class, I can say, to establish a connection to the database. So just do one thing, public connection. Let's create a connection variable. Let's create a constructor. Okay, so now our connection file is ready, database connection file is ready. So now let's import this one. Let's create an object of it. And let's create a function here to get the data from the database. So I'm naming it as a get data. I will pass a DB object so that we can access the connection variable here. And let's fetch all the users. So DB connection / query. So select extract from table name. So I got all the users here. So let's loop all the data, because these are the multiple data, so we have to loop it. So before that, let's create an HTML variable here. Ultimately we have to prepare an HTML, and the table. So let's table, and inside the table we have a tr, inside we have a td. First will be serial number, then name, then email, then contact. Okay, Now let's create rest of the HTML. So inside the tr, let's create another table, next row, td. First will be the serial number, so for that let's create a serial number variable here. By default it is 1, and inside the loop we will increment it. So first, now name, email, contact, and after this let's close the table tag. We will close the table tag outside the loop, right? So let's see whether we are getting the data or not. So echo, let's make the variable HTML is equal to get data. So on click of this, we have a database error. I think I mapped the wrong one. Okay, I just enter the table name. I think it's database. So see, we have all the data. Now our job is to convert this into the PDF. So we already installed the package, so we have to use it. So let's do that. So now what we have to do, after this HTML and before this, we have to import the package. So let's import that package at the top. So how we can require directory, then vendor slash autoload.php. Package is imported. Now we have to let's create one more variable here to make a file name. What will be the file of the, let's say user.pdf. Now we have to create an object of mpdf. mpdf is going to new mpdf slash pdf, and mpdf slash write html. So inside we have to pass the html that we have generated, and we have to download it. So what we will do, so mpdf slash output, we have a function here. Output, it will take a file name variable here first, and then the HTML that we have generated. Let's remove this. Okay. Actually we need this. Okay, so we can see our data is exported and coming as a in table into the PDF. Okay, let's do one more thing. Let's add some styling here. So I already have this style of CSS, so let's see how we can link up with this one. So before that, after this object, we have to do one more thing. mpdf slash write html, and inside this we have to pass this style sheet variable, style sheet, and let's create this one. We don't have style sheet is supposed to file get content, and inside this we have to style.css. So now we have, after this will be the second parameter will be mpdf slash HTML parser parse mode and this header CSS. Okay, and along with this, let me show you how you can save the generated file into the folder. So let's create one more folder here, let's say document, and after this D, what you can do is you have to just add a path of your folder document slash then the file name, and inside instead of D you have to make it F. So let's see. Okay, again it's coming. Oh, this is not applied. I think before generating the HTML we have to apply CSS. Okay, okay, see, now we have a style sheet applied. So, and let's see it is being downloaded in the folder or not. So see, inside the document we have this users.pdf file here, right? So I think it's working now, and we are good. So we have seen how to fetch all the data from the database, and we are generating the HTML based on whatever the data we are getting from the table, and we are exporting that data, or we are converting that data into the PDF, and we are downloading it as well as storing into the folder. So let's do one more thing here, wrap all the thing inside the try catch block. So let's play save. Yes, so I hope guys you understand the concept, and if you feel like any problem, so please comment. I will definitely help you guys and solve your problem. And please like, share and subscribe, and I will leave the source code into the description so you can check it out. And so once you clone the repository, you just have to do a composer install. So everything will be the install, or if you don't want to clone, so this is just a simple project, right? So just create an index.py file, or you can just directly create a script.php file and navigate directly from the browser, and that script.php file will take the data, or you can just hard code the data even. So just you can return the hard coded HTML and return from here, and whatever the HTML you will return, it will be directly converted into the PDF. So with this way we have seen that how we can generate PDF and PHP using the database, and yeah, that's it from the video.